I am Sudipta Vallar. I'm a physiotherapist at Helios, and today we are talking about some wrist strengthening exercises. So wrist is a hinge joint between your distal end of radius and ulna and your first set of carpal bones. Okay, so the movement that are happening in wrist are flexion, extension, ulna deviation and radial deviation. Okay, so what we are going to need is a table and a therabite. Okay, so what we are going to do is, we are going to take the two ends of theraband, okay? So the joint which is there, opposite side of that, we are going to hold it under our foot, okay? You might need to shift a little bit forward for this. Then I am going to lock it in my palm. So now what you will feel is the resistance that is going to come. Okay, so if you can see, the theraband is pretty nice and taut. Make sure that the theraband is at the perpendicular, the 90 degree. Okay, so what you can do is now shift a little bit towards your wrist. Okay, with your other hand, stabilize your wrist. You can take it a little bit behind. Okay, since the wrist does not have a very significant range of motion or a very large range of motion like your elbow or your shoulder, where it's rotating in all the angles, wrist has a pretty restricted range. Okay, so what we are going to do is, we are going to start from the minus degrees. Okay, so this is your neutral and this is your minus. Okay, so we are going to start from that and we are going to pull it up as much as you can and drop it back down. Okay, so one more time, we are going to pull it up, drop it up. Okay, you will feel a lot of stress coming onto your forearm muscles because they are your wrist flexors. Okay, so we are going to pull it up. Make sure that your hand is nice and stabilized, your elbow is not lifting up. So if you're doing this, or if you're, so you're starting from the zero, but when you lift, you're lifting it from your elbow, then it's not your wrist that is working on. Okay, so just stabilize it nicely. Drop it to less than zero or less than neutral and pull it up. Okay, now similarly for your, so this was your flexion. Okay, for your extension, the same position, we're just going to turn the hand around. So your dorsum of your hand is facing up. Okay, again stabilize it, lift it up and drop it up. Okay, start from the minus degrees and nice and steady, lift it up, drop it down. Again, you're going to feel all the pressure on your forearm muscles. Okay, observe, and that's it. So now for radial deviation, we are going to keep your wrist in. So this is what we call pronation and supination. Okay, so these are the movements that are happening at the radial ulna joint and not the wrist movements. So we are going to keep your hand in, so we are going to keep our hand in a mid-prone position. Okay, again stabilize, okay, a little bit proximal to your wrist and lift it up, drop it down. Okay, lift up, so your thumb has to go in the upward direction and drop it down. One more time, up and down. Okay, now for your ulna deviation, what we are going to do is, so it's very difficult to get this movement. So your hand, when it moves towards your little finger, your wrist when it moves to your little finger, it's very difficult to get this movement and strengthen this. Okay, because the range is very minimum and the muscles who are acting on that. So now we are going to do the ulna deviation. Okay, the ranges of the ulna deviation, if you can see, is more than the radial deviation. Okay, but it is very difficult to strengthen this muscle in the same position that we did previous muscles. Okay, so what we are going to do is wrap this theraband nice and tight around your palm. Okay, same position, mid prone. Hold your right hand. So now I'm strengthening the left hand. So I'm holding the right hand up and I'm giving a little bit of pressure. If you can see, this is the normal length of the theraband. I'm giving a little bit of pressure holding it up in a perpendicular manner. Now I'm going to pull this down. Okay, for radial deviation we were pulling it up, but now for ulnar we are going to pull this down and up. Now here, since you're using both the hands, you can't really stabilize your wrist. For that you can put a little bit more of your body weight on your forearm, pull it down and up, and one more time, pull it down and up. Okay, so this is how you strengthen all of your wrist muscles. This is how you strengthen your wrist, and you can improve your wrist flexibility, mobility, or as well as the strength. For the progression, what we can do in the same set of exercises is, so right now we are using the red TheraBand. Okay, so if you are doing say 10 repetitions with this, for the progression you can add a 5 second hold in every movement. So you do the movement, you hold it for 5 seconds, and then you release the movement, and this you can do for 10 times to begin with. Okay, once this TheraBand stops giving you any much of a resistance, you can progress to a higher resistance TheraBand as well. Now these exercises can be done by those who are working in IT, who are working out in gym, because most of the time the wrist is a joint which is ignored by most of the trainers. Okay, you lift heavy weight, you're doing pull-ups, you're not actually putting any pressure on the wrist, you're not strengthening your wrist, you're strengthening all of your body. So it's a small joint, but it needs a lot of strengthening. Otherwise, when you do any of the heavy lifting activities, you might injure it. Or those who are working for a longer time on computer, have mouse, keyboard, desktop, they can injure it, they can wind up into problems like carpal tunnel syndrome, etc. Okay, so hope this was helpful and informative for you all. Thank you.